Welcome back on this Monday to Living Oklahoma. We have Carrie Williams with Rainbow Fleet helping us raise Oklahoma. And a very fitting topic because it's MLK Day. And it's never too early to start learning diversity.
Absolutely.
Right? I mean, Absolutely. The earlier the better. You should come out, you know, just...
The earlier the better. And what we really talk about is that children's classrooms and their homes should be reflective of the world around them. So that when they do go to school or do go to daycare, they're not frightened by people who look differently than they do. And so we have a really great group of activities here that we can talk about, which teaches diversity to young children.
This is great.
And what age is this appropriate for? I mean, just as they start growing up, just because you want them to be familiar with things?
Or? Absolutely. And, you know, we start at toddler years at Rainbow Fleet. We talk about our own cultures. And so for children to understand that there are different cultures in the world, they need to understand their own culture first. Mm-hmm. And so we do that a lot in the toddler years. And then as we move on, we want to make sure that even childcare classrooms are reflective of the world around them. So we have lots of toys and books and games that are sensitive to different cultures, different races, different religions, even, you know, children with some kind of disability. We want to make sure that we have all of that in our classrooms.
Yeah, these are more than action heroes. Actually, I'm already starting to want to play with these.
Really,
but I think of this as I grew up. Like, I grew up in a small little town, and mm-hmm. I never saw the Jewish community represented.
Right.
And I remember going out to, as I, you know, moved on, and I would start to see these groups, like when I was out in Los Angeles, Hasidic Jews that were there, and I was just like, it was weird for me. Mm-hmm. And it seems like here I am, you know, an adult, 30, 40 years old, finally seeing that there's like this whole other world right here in America.
Right.
Had that been something that was normal for me, mm-hmm. it wouldn't have been so much of like that curiosity we don't like things we don't understand.
We are innately afraid of things that are different than we are.
There you go.
And so when we talk about it so early, it teaches children not to be afraid.
Exactly.
It also encourages children to ask questions. It is okay to ask questions mm-hmm. about people who look differently than they do, who practice different religions than we do. It's a good thing to ask questions. It's a good thing to be curious. It is not okay to be afraid. So we have to really be sensitive to that. And one of the ways that we can best illustrate this for toddlers is by the egg test.
Okay.
So tell people what you do here.
So this is great. So this is, we've got a white egg and a brown egg, and they look very different from the outside. But when you crack the eggs into a bowl, they look the same.
Oh, I love that.
So it teaches you that everyone is the same on the inside.
I like that.
That's a great, great way to put it, you know?
Yeah.
They can also hands-on and look at it.
Absolutely.
Exciting. And they can throw it at their brothers and sisters. No,
yes.
I'm kidding. And you have these books. This is a good way.
Yes. Story time is great. So you can learn about different cultures through very easy ways, like story time. We can illustrate that again with the toys that are in the classroom too. We have puppets at Rainbow Fleet that are all different races, religions, cultures. You can see, obviously we have Goldilocks and the Three Bears too, but but we do have, we want our children's toys, our baby dolls, everything to be reflective of the world around us. And so when you integrate story time into play time, that's a great way for children to learn.
I think the one lesson that we teach, or at least my generation has, is that, you know, the difference between boys and girls, obviously, you know, and you treat girls with respect and that sort of thing. And I think that needs to be broadened out to say, you know, respect everybody, and there's differences. Mm-hmm. And those differences of opinion are actually what makes us learn and grow, and it's okay to ask questions, I guess.
Absolutely. And one of the greatest ways that we practice diversity at home is by sampling foods from other cultures.
Oh, yeah.
So you can learn to cook Asian cuisine. We have a member of our family who is from Vietnam, and so he is always introducing us to different
foods. I love
that. I think that is wonderful.
Yeah. All right. You know, and by the way, they have an unbelievable resource there at Rainbow Fleet that is there for you and for the taking. And if you need help when it comes to child care and parenting, Rainbow Fleet is there to help. You can check them out on the web at rainbowfleet.org. Their phone number here in Oklahoma City is 405-525-3111. They're back every other week with more expert advice for parents who are raising Oklahoma.
They also have a number for those who speak Spanish. It's 525-8783. It's a new year, which could mean a new you.
Oh, yeah. You